about Tokyo. Today, we talk about bread groups associated to complex reflection groups. So my plan is first, I want to introduce complex reflection groups. And then I will do a new orientation of BEDER. This is the bread group type BEDER. I will define soon. And then I will talk about the interpretation as geometry. Okay, let V be a complex vector space. And let's say the dimension R. A non-identity element in GLV is called a complex reflection. Fixes a tight plane clockwise. So it's a generalization of real reflections. But for real reflections, it preserves hyperplane and usually it has order two. But here, the only requirement is that it fixes a hyperplane. So i.e., it will denote hx as the kernel of x minus the identity map is of dimension minus 1. This hx is called reflection okay. A typical example like this. Let's take a two-dimensional complex vector space and let X be a linear map sending Z1, Z2 to Z2, Z1. It commutes the coordinates. In matrix, we can write it as 0, 1, 1, 0. This is a complex reflection, and the reflection hyperplane is given by this and second example is x send z1 z2 to z1 and omega z2. So in matrix form, this is 1 0 0 omega, and it preserves the hyperplane in by Z2, zero. So usually here we take omega a root of unit so that this x has finite order. Okay, this is complex reflection and a complex reflection group. A complex reflection group is a group which is defined by a complex reflections. Is a finite group. Let me give you an example. Let DE be the set of all DE Rostov units. Means that there is only one entry, non-zero entry at each column and row. For example, okay, these two matrices are monomial matrices, and you can easily say that this M is a finite reflection group. Okay. And G. Instead of matrices in M, such that the product of a I to the D power from A I J branch O non-zero entries. This is the definition of complex reflection group of type EER. Okay. And it is classified in 1955. Shepherd and Tom. Classified all finite, irreducible finite complex reflection groups, and so in this classification, G, D, E, E, R, they are finite complex reflection groups, and there are four exceptional groups used by G4, G5, G37. Okay. These are classification. The complement of the reflection hyperplanes, the union of reflection. So, given a finite complex reflection group, think about all complex reflections inside the group and take the reflection hyperplanes and the union and the complement from this vector space. And then the PG is pi on x. This is a pure Bray group. Associated to this complex reflection group, and BG is pi 1 of X mod G. This is Bray group. So in this talk, I am interested in this Bray group, BG, and probably may imagine that it is known that this complement is has complex universal curve of X. Conjectural. It is not much obvious. It is conjectured. It was a long-standing conjecture, and it was very recent, and very recently this conjecture was completely solved. So because this complement has contract of the universal curve, this Bray group has finite k pi 1. Let me give you some example of Bray groups. So, most example. Let's think about P1, 1, 1. Okay, so if DE is 1, then mu DE is just 1, and so GDER is just set up of monomials. It is just a commutation matrices. So this one should be the arcing group of type A power minus 1. Like, you know, I mean, this B means the Bray group of type A R minus 1. Usually we write in A and arcing group of type A R minus 1. Okay. So this is representation like this. Sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma r minus 1. So this is the connotation sigma 1 to sigma r minus 1, and relation is sigma I plus 1, sigma I plus 1, sigma I, sigma I plus 1, and sigma I, sigma j, and sigma j. Difference between this and this two. Okay, so this is the Bray group. Right here. Bray group. Okay. So probably most of you are studying familiar with this linking diagram. This vertices corresponds to generators, and if there is no edge, then these two generators commute, and if there is an edge, then there are order two relation, order any rank three relation like this. Okay, and E 2. So this is for corresponding complex reflection group is two matrices where the entries are E through the unit, and this is
the red group of I to E time.
The corresponding capsid group is the symmetry group of regular E bond. So, okay, so this is presentation like T1, T0, the T1, T0, T1, the alternating product of length E starting from T1 is same as T0, T0. So we usually use this T1, T0, this thinking diagram. So the corresponding capsid group is the symmetry group of regular E bond, that means dihedral group. The symmetry of this E bond. Let's think about the term T0, E1. So this means T0 means that the reflection with respect to this line, and T1 means the reflection with respect to this line. Then and if we apply T0 and T1, this is just rotation, and we rotate E times, then we have identity, and this relation comes from that. And also, we can make another presentation where we should think about all reflections in the dihedral group. So, we have T2, like this. So T0, T1, and TE minus 1 with E reflections, and the relation is T1, T0 is T2, T1 is TE minus 1, TE minus 2 is T0, TE. So here you can see that T1, T0 is reflection this way, so this is also E, 2 pi over E rotation, and these, all of these rotations, so they must be the same. So usually we draw a picture like this. So T0, T1, T2, E minus 1, and so there are E vertices on circle which corresponds to E generators, and these two means that so product of two of these generators like T1, T0 or T2, T1, they are all the same. Examples, and there have been so many several studies on these complex reflection groups, the geometry and algebra and combinatorics of these complex reflection groups and bridge groups and associated Hecke algebras. And my motivation is the region of basis. I don't want to give the exact distinction of Gaussian IQ is pretty complicated. So anyway, Gaussian IQ, this means that there is a very nice monoid whose group of fractions is that group. And this monoid has very nice properties, which implies that this group has very nice properties. So the core consequences is that this group properties of Gaussian group, for example, is torsion free.
Thank you.
what I brought. Now let me talk about our presentations. Let me introduce the presentation. Given by these three people provided an offset like diagram. This and S3, S4, SR, P5, D0, E, and double S here. So this is a diagram for the Bray group, BER. This diagram should interpret it like this. This group has generators. T1, T0, and S, where S is S3, S4, S1. So these vertices correspond to generators and relations. So this diagram gives the relation. So if there is no edge, then that those two generators commute. And if there is an edge, then there are all the three length three relation. For example, S3, S4, S3 is S4, S3, S4 like this. So there is edge here. So this means that T1, S3, T1, the same as S3, T1, S3 like this. This edge may well E means that there is a length E relation, like I to E case. And this double edge means that there's also a length 4 relation, which is F3 and T1, T0. So, anyway, relations. So, great relations. T-I, S3, T-I, S3, T-I, S3, T-1, which corresponds to these two edges, and T-I, S-J, S-J, T-I, where I, 0, 1, and J, T0, S3, T1, T0, S3 is S3, T1, T0, S3, T1, T0. So, okay. And T1, T0, T1, T times me is T0, T1, T0. Recently, from something gave a new presentation for this group. So their presentation diagrams looks like this.
T0, T1, T2, T1. E minus 2, there are also axis here. S3, S4, S5.
If you compare these two diagrams, these two parts are identical, and this part, this I to E part, is dualized like this. So, and you can also see the relations from this diagram, the general first. Here, let us E S, where T is Ti, I is E, and S is the same as before, S3 is for itself. Relations.
S as before, and TR S3 TR in S3 TR S3 and TI SJ TI SAS SJ TI R in CE and J R.
This is a new presentation. The goodness of this presentation is that this presentation gives a geographic structure. So in that sense, this one is better than that one. So we are trying to use the same idea to the break group of type DER. So, as we broke, the presentation of this group is like this. This is a diagram for this break group. So this part is the same. So this is almost a break group, and okay, this double H means that there is order 4, length 4 relation between T1, T0, and H3. And okay, let me write the generators. Union T0 T1 union S and relations. So play relations on S before, and okay, TR S3 T1 T0 S3 is S3 T0 S3 T1 And the relation regarding Z is that C T1 D0 is T1 D0 C and C T1 T0 T1 and what of length E plus 1. So that's from C and T1 D0 T1 D0 T1 and so the whole water length is E plus 1. This same as T0 Z T1 T0. So you can, here you can see that if we if we model this group by C equal 1, then this one is exactly the presentation of DEER. Okay, so and in this presentation, there's no relation between T1 and T0. So you can think that there's no relation between these two areas. So you can think that there is an infinite relation here. So our idea is to dualize these I to infinite part like this. Okay, so if there is this edge is enabled by E, we put E generators on circle. Here, this edge, we can think that this edge is enabled by infinity, so we have to put infinitely many. Sorry? I think here I should be at least 3. If I is 2, then there is no gel here. And these groups are very simple. So we put R n is 3. Yeah. Anyway, so this edge can be considered as, we think that this edge is the infinity, so we want to put infinitely many vertices and circle. So in my case, I want to write this T0, T1, T2, T minus 1, T minus 2, S3, S4, SR, and conditions. This and got it. So Z extend here to here. You can see that this diagram is very similar to this one. We refresh this circle and it's an infinite line. Okay. So you can usually guess what is the relations and generators and relations. Generators are S and the TIs and Z here, and relations, there are great relations on SIs, and there are relations between TI and 3 as before, and okay, and there is the I to E type relation on this one, like T2, T1 is same as T1, T0, which is same as T0, T inverse, T minus 1, and like this. And this Z acts like this. Z Ti is Ti minus E. See? And Z Sj is Sj. So in this new presentation, we don't have these two relations. And Okay, in this presentation, I mean, I don't like these three relations. These three relations is, you know, looks a little complicated here. Okay, so we have very natural relations. The action of Z, conjugation by Z, translates Ti to Ti minus E and fixes space. So, okay. So we use the same idea here. These two relations can be rewritten like Z T I, Z inverse T I minus E, and Z S J, Z inverse is S J. So this means that this break group has semi-dynamic product structure. Yes. Let B infinity infinity R in the group defined by generators adjoint by S union T. So here S means S3 SR and T means TR and C. And the relations on S and T. So in this presentation, just forget these two relations. And we have this B infinity infinity R. Then B D E E R. It has to be two. It is strictly corrupted by Z, and D infinity infinity R.
This one?
Yeah, thank you. And in this semi-direct product, the action of Z is shift of index by E. And if we use different value of E, then it has different shape. Especially if it is a monomorphism. So sending SJ to SJ, T
pi to pi z to e star of z.
So here the conjugate, the conjugation by z sends ti to ti minus z, and here conjugation by z sends ti to ti minus 1. So if we take this power of, I mean, these two z are different. This z is contained here, and this z is here. Anyway, so we have monomorphism. Yes. So if we consider this group as a subgroup of this group, and this is an index E subgroup. And now talk about interpretation. Geometric. Let's think about, let's say D1R is good. So here, the relation like Z, T, I, Z inverse is T, I minus E, I minus 1, because E equals 1 here. So, then ti can be like this. Ti is z inverse ti minus 1 z, and this is z minus square ti minus 2 z square, and if we keep going, this is z to minus I t 0. So with this simulation, we can delete every ti except d0. So d1 of is verified. Z d0 and s. We can delete every ti except d0, and this relation, t1, t0, t0, t minus 1. This t1 is z inverse t0, z. T0. The same as t0 times t minus 1 is z t0. And then moving z inverse here to z here, and z inverse here to z here, then we have t0, z, t0, z is z, t0, z, t0. So we have length 4 relation between t0 and t0, and z. In fact, is isomorphic to B, B, I think the type R is thinking divergence. This C here, D0, that's the 3. This is our integral of type B. So combining this monomorphism and this identity, this isomorphism, we can regard this red group BDEER as a fine index subgroup of this acting group type B. So we have several corollaries from that.
BDEER invests in BDEER. This is isomorphic to arcing group of type DR.
And it is well known that this is a bridge group on annulus. And I put for this interpretation, like BR was 1:1. Okay. Okay, this is means that, so think of a R strand, like you know, number of the strands from 1 to R, then sigma square is this break, the sigma square, and sigma 2, and sigma 3, like this. So in this case, the first strand is a pure strand. So if you, that means if you think about induced permutation, then this one goes to this one. So the first strand is pure. And the next, Si goes to I minus 3, goes to the Si, and this one goes to sigma I, and Z is sent to C to E here, and this one is sent to sigma 1 to this part, and this, the TI are sent to Ti here, so from that, this one is Ti is sent to sigma 1 to the minus 2 E I, 2 I sigma 2 sigma. And if you think about the homomorphism from this bracket group to C, it's the winding number. So we want to measure the winding number, the winding number of the strands except the first, winding number with respect to the first strand of the other strand. For example, here, this strand winds once this first strand, and the other strand does not wind the first strand. So this is wind number one. So this is homomorphism sending sigma I to zero, I two, and sigma one square to one. So under this interpretation, I can think that, so let me see, this Si goes to sigma I, so it goes to zero, and Z goes to sigma to the E, and this goes to E, and Ti goes to zero. So we have interpretation that. Is isomorphic to 1 pure R plus 1 phrase G is that winding number of G is 0. It is well known that this group is a Gaussian group, and this is by every Gaussian groups are bi-automatic. So, and finite index subgroup of a bi-automatic group is bi-automatic. So, BEE is bi-automatic. So, it has solvable word and condition problem. And D-E-E-R is finite. I mean, it is already known that, the exterior of reflex hypercranes have contractive universal curvature. So that means that this group has finite k pi 1. Also obtain the result using this interpretation that it is known that this group has finite k pi 1, and because this is a finite subgroup, we can take this finite coupling, we have finite k pi 1.
What's your finite k pi 1? Finite
concept? For this one, you can take the complement of reflex hyperplanes, then that has a finite homotopy type. Okay. Well, I mean, you can use a Gaussian structure and you can build so-called a normal form complex for that. Anyway. And so, we need this root of two. That means that g to the k power is, if this to k power is same as h to k and k is non-zero, then g and h are conjugate. So this means that, so if we have two roots, then they are conjugate. This is the corollary of this group. We have shown that Anjung and I show that the roots of uniqueness of that property holds in this group. I already have time, so let me explain quickly. This comes from that on the other hand, I show that. So
G and H as elements of the unconcerned.
But so one pure are concerned break.
And the K is a K plus some K non-zero. Then exists X in B R plus 1, 1 such that H is X, G, X inverse, so
G and H are conjugate
and winding number of X is 0.
Okay, so if G, we have two elements G and H here, then we can consider they are elements in this group. And using that result, because they have same power, there is a conjugating element X, whose winding number is 0. So we can think that this X, in fact, is contained in this group. So using this result, we have this uniqueness of roots of conjugacy.
Okay,
fine.
So this is very usually.
This is a topic of this.
Okay.
Thank you.